So I'm Sarah Turner. I'm a data engineer in Oracle Vision Laboratory, and I'm specifically in charge of the 3D data interoperability and sustainability. So I will today present the database for the collaborative documentation of the digital data for Notre Dame project. Today I will first give an overview of the ArcoGrid framework, and then I will present in detail the project module that is one part of the framework that is used in the NDAM ecosystem. I will continue with the interactions of between ArcoGrid and the other parts of the NDAM ecosystem, and I will finish with OpenTheso interconnections with NDAM ecosystem and with ArcoGrid in particular. So ArcoGrid is a tool which we have been using in our unit for more than 15 years now, and which was born from a need of our team to have a tool for managing the documentation of 3D projects that we conduct in our laboratory. And at the time, there was the concern to document the files by proposing to create metadata passports in order to ensure a perennial preservation of data. So CNRS and ArcoVision developed the ArcoGrid framework. And after its redesign in 2017, ArcoGrid can now be represented as a sort of galaxy which projects gravitate toward a common core that is the framework. The goal is to manage digital resources and enrich them with the resources adapted to different needs while remaining interoperable. So the security of the tools is ensured by Humanum with its infrastructure. The robustness of the tools is based on reliable open source technologies, and the interoperability is ensured by the use of thesauri like OpenTheso or geonames for location, Periodo, or that's it. So at the moment, each module has specific features. And for instance, the stereotech there is already harvested by French repository. And for instance, the 3D data repository benefits from the assigning of a perennial identifier, the DOA. So however, not all the features are now available for every module, but we are working on implementing all the features in every module. So this is the project module used to gather all the documentation for 3D projects that are useful in order to model or rebuild artifact or archaeological site in 3D. Most of the resources are images, but not only. And it is possible to store any file format in the database. So resources are heterogeneous, but open source file formats are strongly recommended for safer preservation and reuse of the files. Images files were the first to be integrated into ArcoGrid, being in the heart of the documentation system. And for the 3D files like OBJ or PLY, we offer two kinds of visualization, one based on the 3D viewer developed within the Italian CNR team, the 3D Hub, and the other one is based on the PO3 viewer. Video were recently taken into account thanks to this project. JSON and zip file have been recently integrated thanks to another project. Audio files are also integrated now. Text and PDF are also present in ArcoGrid. And the spreadsheet files appeared very recently but are only partly integrated at the moment. So between brackets, there are the names of ArcoGrid root folders. This is the first level categorization of the resource. And still for the Notre Dame project, we wanted to reinforce this categorization by proposing for each root folder two subcategories, collect or production. in order to better transcribe the origin of the data. And at last, the origin of the data is also specified by the name of the working group it comes from. So when you enter data into Hacker Grid database, you can add metadata on it. So in the database, you have the resources and the metadata of the resources. And you can manage the rates on the data and on the metadata very precisely, thanks to the use of folders and user profile. So each folder is either public or private. And by default, the status of the folder is private. You have to be logged in to access the resource. And in private folders, you can choose to set read-only or read-write rights for the metadata. And then you set to choose the rights either to one user or to a group of users. And depending on the user profile, the rights on the data and on the metadata are not exactly the same, as you can see on the table. So let's see an example now on the interface. You can browse data from the folder tree structure here on the left. And when a folder has a public status, every resource of the folder is freely accessible and downloadable. You can see it on the picture. There is a download icon. And if the logged in user has sufficient rights, he can edit the metadata and make some changes on it. And in the right picture, you can see that the data is in a private folder and the logged user does not have sufficient right to edit the resource. It may be a guest user with restricted rights, for instance. So let's see now the data organization of the database. We have three main concepts: the folder, the file, and the object. Folders can stand for a logical organization of the resource. A folder can be issued from the data synchronization on disk, and in that case, it's a simple folder and contain files that physically exist on the disk. But folders can also be created from the interface by authorized user, and in that case, they are virtual folders, and they can manage collections of data. They can contain objects or files. And then there are files that represent the physical resources on disks, and the object that is mainly defined by a name. And the first physical object that we have created for the Notre Dame project are the stone object, the claveaux, the keystones. And then we have the passport metadata. It's a set of metadata values that have been filled in for any kind of resource, file, object, or folder. And then the comment, you can add a comment or on a file or an object or a folder, and it allows you to add freely a comment on the data. If the user doesn't have the right to edit the metadata, he can add a comment on the resource. And then, in order to annotate or enrich the data, we manipulate several types of data, like the tags of thesaurus that are interoperable preferably and issued from OpenTeso or GeoNames or Periodo. Nomenclature is another sort of thesaurus that are used to define a complex location. And then metadata. They are organized in models, preferably standards models like the Dublin Core, but also customized models. The important thing is to be able to align or map each metadata to entity of standard ontologies like the CIDOC CRM, for instance, and then it would be easier to extract this data in order to be harvested by other repositories. So collaborative management and semantic enrichment of the data are made possible by indexing the data by batch or by unit resource, by tagging them, or by creating collections with selections of resources, and by adding comments, of course. So let's see now how to manage comments and add thesaurus tags. So here we have the folder tree structure and the collection, and there you have your icon to make a comment. You can choose which group, working group you have, and make a comment. So that's just an example. Then here you have the list of the comments that have been done under resources. And for instance, let's see the first one. There is a comment. And if you browse the data by the Thesaurus page and you look for this concept, and there is an autocomplete, then you search and there is no result for this concept. So now let's go back to this resource that is an images. Then you can see the image, the metadata, the comment that have been made on the data, and then let's add a keyword. So here you type the keyword with an autocomplete. Okay, then you can register it. And then, if you go back to the Thesaurus page and look for this concept, the same one, then you can see this. This is one resource. And in the page of the resource now, this keyword appeared, yes, in this area. Afterwards, you can also delete the comment if you want to, okay, if it's useless. Now, let's see now the latest features. I have implemented lately the QR code that allows to directly display all the information related to one physical object, for instance. It's a global representation of an object. So you have the pre-visualization, the 3D model, the metadata, and all the associated files with the objects. Another feature is the search engine. It allows you to search in the database, search for words, for a type of document, or for a tag of thesaurus, or for a metadata value, and you can search in a precise folder or subfolder. And you can also use the fact that it is an API, so you can save the search and share it with other people. And then very lately, the last developed feature is the implementation of a TrapIIF server to display images. And the main improvement compared to the previous technology is an impressive pyramidal zoom. And recently, we implemented successfully also the use of TrapIIF server to display all the pages of PDF files directly in the browser. So here are some useful links if you want to visit ArcureGrid or Notre Dame project in ArcureGrid, and the data 3D data repository where the project will be safely stored afterwards. Oh no. So let's see now the Endem ecosystem. It's composed of many elements, and it's only a part of the system that is shown now. First of all, there is Esmeralda to make the depot, the deposit. once the data are validated, the data is stored in the human inbox. And then data is synchronized into ArcureGrid database. And actually, at the moment, ArcureGrid is sharing data with other elements of the ecosystem, like OpenTesor for Thesaurus management. I will describe just after. And the 3D viewer with which I share the metadata thanks to REST API. So let's see now the exploitation of OpenTesor Thesaurus in the Endem ecosystem. In OpenTesor, Thesaurus are prepared, structured, enriched, and aligned with other standard Thesaurus. And above all, each concept has a perennial identifier, so they can be exploited in different components of the Endem ecosystem. For instance, in ArcureGrid, there, when you click on a keyword, you are directly connected to the concept page in OpenTesor. And in OpenTezos, they also use the REST API to display external information, like the linked corpus, that in that case is Archer Grid. So you can go to Archer Grid directly from OpenTezos. And finally, the tesori are integrated in different parts of the ecosystem thanks to REST API, and extracted data is normalized and respect the international standards, the RDF, SCoS, JSON, JSON-LD, and Turtle. And for instance, the entire tesori is stored in Archer Grid database with the ARC identifiers, of course. And then we are able to link data between Archer Grid and OpenTezos. And thanks to this identifier, we can bounce from one database to another and ensure the interconnection with all the elements of the ADAM ecosystems.